The Liberal Party licking their wounds.
I think the first thing we need to do as a party is to keep our cool.
As the government became the first to win an opposition seat in a by-election in more than a century.
I think we need to take a lesson from Aston. We need to listen to what the community is saying.
And the hits keep on coming. The latest news poll showing the coalition's primary vote has plunged to its lowest level since...
They are in a lot of trouble, mate, and they've really got to go and have a good look at themselves.
While Anthony Albanese extends his lead as preferred PM.
They lost the last federal election, yet Peter Dutton is pursuing every one of their policies. If you want someone to sit as opposition leader who can clench his jaw manfully, that's Peter Dutton.
We were 10 months into a new government. We're setting the benchmark, we're setting the markers as to what we're going to do and what we're going to offer.
However you slice it, the Libs and their leader need an image makeover. That kind of makeover.
Let me finish.
It's clear the party has got to move back to the centre. It's got to get back to where the voters are. Now, the challenge for Dutton, people have a very clear view of him as very much a hard right culture warrior.
Jason Wood, one of the only two Liberal MPs left in Metro Melbourne, says it's all about the sell.
So I spoke to Peter Dutton and said we need to be out there selling you and our colleagues need to be selling you.
The idea of putting Peter Dutton on posters everywhere, Peter is on posters everywhere in Victoria. But they're Labor Party posters, and there's a reason for that.
I think image only goes skin deep. I think it's a problem of substance.
Dutton insists he will remain in the top job and rebuild the party, his leadership looking safe for now.
Problem is finding an alternative. When you look at the people on the front bench with him, there's no obvious successor.
So can the Liberal Party brand recover?
Liberal Senator Andrew Bragg joins us now. Senator, Peter Dutton wasn't able to answer the question of what went wrong yesterday. Why do you think you lost?
Well, I think that there are many factors in the Victorian by-election of Aston. I'm not an expert on what's happened on the ground there. What I can say is that it's very important that the Liberal Party is a party that puts forward economic policy ideas, but also one that keeps away from marginal issues.
What does that mean?
Well, it means that we have to put forward new ideas, particularly as Peter goes into his second year as leader. I would expect we'd be putting forward new initiatives around things like housing and emissions reduction, for example. But it's equally important that we maintain our position as a mainstream party.
I don't understand how the Liberal Party brand is going to recover when Mr Dutton has said that he won't shift the direction of the party. Does that mean that you're expecting the population to come to you?
So what I mean when I say a party of the mainstream, what I mean is a party that keeps away from marginal issues, unnecessary culture war issues and unnecessary divisions in the society. And there is a tendency on the fringes to Americanise our politics, and I think that would be a fundamental misreading of where the Liberal Party needs to go to maintain our status as a mainstream party.
Lots of questions over whether the leader is the problem. Peter Dutton said he's not going anywhere. Are you behind him as leader?
The answer is not to change the leader. The answer is to develop more policies, particularly in the economic space, around things like housing, emissions reduction, for example. And as I say, maintaining our position as a mainstream political party that doesn't move into the fringes.
The problem is it's a mainstream political party that no one seems to be voting for at the moment. If there's no problem with Peter Dutton, then how would you sell him to the Australian public as a leader?
But people are voting for the Liberal Party still. I mean, at the last federal election, we received 36% of the primary vote. Even at Aston, that was a 40% of the primary vote result. And, of course, the New South Wales state election saw quite a close result in the end where, after 12 years, Labor couldn't even get to a majority. So,
aren't by-elections supposed to send a message to the sitting government? Really, by-elections, with this result, sent a message to the Liberal Party.
Look, it was a bad result, there's no question about that. But what it means is we need to be focused on policy. Policy is the reason people vote for political parties.
But increasingly, they're one on personality also. And do you think that maybe that is a problem for Mr Dutton that is insurmountable, that real or imagined, he's misunderstood by the Australian electorate or they've decided they don't want him?
Well, I think it's early days. I mean, Peter is a warm and consistent person. and I found him to be a very honest person to deal with. Now, not everyone in politics is honest to start with. That won't surprise you. But I think that the more people get to see him, the more that they will like him.
I guess we'll find out, Andrew. In the meantime, thank you so much for your time tonight.
OK, no worries. Thanks.